Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Gallaudet University and the Bison Fieldhouse for today's United East Conference men's basketball game between St. Mary's College of Maryland and Gallaudet University. Today, the athletics department and the basketball program are celebrating Black History Month with special presenters during halftime, exhibits in the lobby, and music DJ Nadija Davis and special Black History Month t-shirts. Thank you for being here to show your support. Reminder all fans to be kind and courteous to each other, the teams, officials, and game staff. Thank you. Now let's meet today's team. First, the starters for the Seahawks. Back guard, number 2, Jaden Walker. Back guard, number 3, Darren Alexander. Back guard, number 14, Micah Memory. Back forward, number 12, Khalid Johnson, and at forward, number 13, Nan Fisher. St. Mary's is coached by Chris Harney, assisted by Thomas Schiffer, Ben Kling, and Naive Menon. And now the starters for your Bison. Back guard, number 4, Kyle Florio. Back guard, number 10, Preston Kelly. At forward, number 23, Enow Otto Jr. At forward, number 32, Les Mbogo. And at center, number 20, Alex Ansern-Perl. Now, Gallaudet is coached by Kevin Kovacs, assisted by Pete Westholder, Anton Jackson, Kazim Babatunde. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Nobody might go through up. Thank you. Overall knowledge people had that opportunity, and I was fortunate enough to capitalize on it. I don't plan to belabor you and go on and on with my speech tonight. However, there is something that I want to share. There's one particular memory that stays with me. You know, what's now that SLCC on campus used to be a gymnasium that was called Hughes Gym. And Hughes Gym was right next to HMB. I recall it was a day that I recruited all the students from HMB to follow me over to Hughes Gym. Right? And it was a surprise as far as to the rest of them while I was doing this. But when they followed me in, come to find out there was actually an NBA team practicing here on Gallaudet's campus. And the NBA team at the time were the San Francisco Warriors, which are known today as the Golden State Warriors. But at that time, they were known as the San Francisco Warriors. I can recall they had different clinics going on in the gym, different areas where athletes were practicing certain drills. And some of you might not know who this gentleman is, but there was one particular player by the name of Ricky Berry. And Rick Berry is an absolute Hall of Fame athlete in the list of top 100 NBA players. And he's a very unique individual. He was known for his phenomenal shooting. However, there was also a unique way that he would shoot the ball sometimes. Whenever he was shooting free throws, well, normally when he shoot a regular shot, he would shoot how you typically see players shoot. But when he shoot a free throw, he did a grandfather style. And he just kind of locked that thing up. So all of us were in the gym, just watching him shoot free throw after free throw, just lobbing it up. And I remember, I counted at least 100 straight free throws back to back. And when I say he did 100 straight free throws, I'm not talking about those shots that ran out there with you. I'm talking about nothing but that. Shot after shot after shot. So I'm like, okay, makes sense. The guy plays for the NBA. He should be able to do that. But with all that, I'm glad that you're able to allow me to come tonight and share a few remarks. And for the men's basketball team, keep on fighting. Let's get out of here.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh! person. Yeah. You know,
thank you.
Julia, Julia.